Okay, the next part in the process is you take the raw sap from the tree and you got to remove a lot of water. In general, it takes about 30 gallons of sap to make a gallon of maple syrup. So that's 29 gallons of water you've got to boil out. But it's actually pretty simple because all you're doing is boiling. And really, when you're making maple syrup, you're not limited by the number of trees you have. You're more limited by how quickly you can boil down the sap. So what we have here is a kind of a homemade evaporator. As you can see here, all I did was I just stacked some concrete blocks. Got a stainless steel rectangular pan right in the middle and just built a fire underneath. And in the back, built a stack for the chimney. So try to get a really hot fire going on underneath the pan. Get the draft going up the chimney, and as you can see here, you can boil off a lot of steam pretty quick. That's why I'm having trouble seeing. So anyway, you just let it boil. You just boil it and keep boiling it. What we have here is a preheater, and this is where you add the cold sap. And the nice thing about doing this is that you can add cold sap to here and not lose your boil, because over here is a little valve where you can drip the sap, the cold sap, slowly into here, so that it won't stop the boiling, because you want to keep it going as fast as you can. Then I have here a skimmer. It's just a little colander I bought. I think it was a dollar or $2, really cheap. As it's boiling, it's nice to kind of skim off this foam, and every once in a while you'll get things that fly in there, like a leaf or just little pieces of stuff that's blowing through the air. So it's nice to kind of skim that stuff out of there. But what you do is you just keep boiling it, and you can test it to see when it's almost maple syrup. But what you want to do is you want to pull it out of here right before it's maple syrup. And the way you do that is with something called a hygrometer. I'll show you how to use that when we get into finishing the syrup. But basically what it does is it tests the syrup to see what the density is. Let's get away from the steam. Because as it gets closer to maple syrup, right now it has the density of water. As it gets closer to maple syrup, the density will increase. Till eventually when you get maple syrup, you see it's pretty dense and thick and syrupy. So what you want to do is you want to get right before it's maple syrup, you want to pull it out of here and take it inside and do what we call finishing, and then that will be the subject of the next video.